Now, once a polytaito, you may think that doesn't sound quite right, but believe me, once a polytaito it is, and in this case it was Goldilopper's. Goldilopper's triddly how in the early mordy, and she falloloped down the steps. Oh, unfortunate for cracking of the eggers and the sheeps and the buttery, full falollop and graze the kneeclappers. So she had a vasalubrious, rub it on and a quick healy huff, and that was that. So off she went, and she would triddly how down the garbage path, and at the left, right-hand side goal, she passed a poo-pom. It was a humus heapy in the garbage. But never mind, she lost her whale. Now, this is a sadness, dear Childers, because in the slight misty haze, which all foray, let me tell you, in the ephemeral foray, there's always a fairy control where the misty risey huff there, and so she was completely lost it. Oh, folly, folly. There was a cotty, so she went up, all ready with a basket, and picked up the butter, all that, with a little bit of birch, she'd scrape it off and rub it in down her clothesy. Mum would be cross, but never mind. On the door. This little cotty had a jar on the door, so she went in. Nobody there. Three baseload of porry on the tabloid, all slightly steamy huff, and nobody out. She called out, "Anyone home?" Nobody. Folly, folly. And the little hunger was with her, so she falloloped a taste out of the first basil. This was the large base load, and too over-salty for the flame, spitty how. Oh, dear. Now, the mid-load was a middle flabe, which was not too over-salt and a sugar flabe on her saliva glam, and it wasn't, of course, quite satisfactory. So she did a tasty most in the little base load there, and it was a joy. And, oh, pardlo, as she stuffled it down. Oh, dear. Now, this was great, but there was also a little tiredness in the Goldiloppers, and she sat on a three-lebber stool, and tock for lolloper, all the lebbers floating across the corm, sat on a bocus there, bruisy most. Well, still there was no one around, so she went prrrp-tock up the stair loaders, and she found a large bedding, not a capac got eider down, but stuffed with feathers, but here and there a stalk, as you know, it was a big feathersy eaglode, and it stuck in her back, and it was most uncomfortable. So she saw the cotty, and in this cot she did lay down deep sleevers under the eiderdobe. Well, while she was thus sleepy and a deep dream of peaks, then up came the bears into the cotty. Now the father bold bear looking around and say, "Who's been tasting in stuff for my porry? Oh dear." And then the mother bear looking in her baseload of porry and said, "Who'd be tasting in my porry? Oh, I'd never finger." So the small bear came and said, "She's my base load and falloloping all down, mum. Oh, dear, look, it's empty. You're not scratching on the bottom." And there was a general consternale uproar and complaint about the three-lebbered stool there, all the bits and the floaty, and so they had a look-in around the house loader. Brr-tock, big bear. Brr-tock, middle bear. Brr-st-t-t. They all went up the stair loaders, and soon there was a dent discovery in Mum and Dad's bedling, when the dirty footmark was where she did her trotly over and how, and then into the copst. And the little bear saw it. "Oh, look at it, Mum! This lame's the Goldiloppers!" But at this mode, she jumped up in the middle of her deep dream sleep piecey, out of the wind load, slide it and huffaloed out of the drain pikers, and through the foray fast a whale. And they all looked such consternal through the wind load, they hadn't time to say, "You naughty girlage."